Hi, I'm Philip.
And Sheila.
And we're from Colchester, Vermont. And I guess the part that resonates the most with me about this exhibit is the fact that racism wasn't really the start of slavery. And actually, you know, people that lived in America in the really, really early time periods, everyone worked together, lived together, people got married, they fought together. And that this idea of whiteness or blackness was not really a thing, and then it kind of became a thing because of greed, I guess. I don't know.
Maybe
control and power. And so it's sad that we created this social stigma based on greed, money, and power. And the other thing that resonated with me is that only 5% of the population controlled slavery. Like, that was it.
Right.
And the other 95% of the population, like, you know,
went along with it.
I don't come from a rich family. So, you know, although I am European American, I don't come from a very rich family. So I don't think my family had any slaves. There's no history of it for us. So that was also interesting to me. What about you?
Well, and I think it's interesting how what we teach in schools versus what maybe is the real history.
Yeah.
And thinking about like the early part of slavery being more about like indentured servitude, which happened in Europe for years prior, but ended differently and transpired differently than in the U.S.
And we had a whole civil war, whereas in Great Britain, slave
just
owners
ended.
Were, well, they paid people. They paid them out, and I mean, we didn't do that. So, but this is a very powerful museum, and
thank you.
I think everyone, all Americans, should come here.
Mm-hmm.